This is a cross-life broadcasting event.
Fulfilling our mission.
Preaching the gospel.
Defending the faith.
Calling out heresy.
Declaring biblical truths that will change your life.
Taking the gospel around the world.
Church, the way it should be.
Some of my notes while he was jabbering. So I just want to say a couple things about mothers. And what I'm going to say today is probably not the typical Mother's Day sermonette or whatever you want to call it. But Mother's Day is a very special day. And it's a time that we set aside to honor the mothers and people who have raised us to be who we are. And because like he said, let's face it, you know, we wouldn't be here without our mama. But I want to look at it a little bit different. And there have been times, you know, in my life that I've sat in a Mother's Day sermon, you know, like this, and they were talking about how perfect we are and how good we are and how much effect we have on our children's life, which is, you know, maybe not perfect, but, you know, we have an effect on our children's life. But mothers are viewed all the time as a loving, caring person. These are the attributes of a wonderful mother. But if I'm honest with you all today, there are times that I've thought to myself that while I was sitting in the sermon that I'm not quite adding up to what they're saying that I should be. Now, don't get me wrong. I absolutely love and adore my children with every fiber of my being. But sometimes, you know, they're saying all that, and you're like, oh, man, maybe I didn't do that this morning. Maybe I didn't get up and do what he said I should have been doing this morning. And there's nothing that I wouldn't give within reason for my children. I'm sure one of those Mother's Days I've lost my cool or was frustrated trying to get out the door and maybe raise my voice when I shouldn't have and didn't handle things in the right way. But then I sat in the congregation and I pretended like I did. You know, I had the smile on my face, had the wonderful family, the picture-perfect kids and all that good stuff. But I wanted to make sure they all were dressed alike and they smiled just right for the picture that I was going to put on social media later. Being a mom is the hardest but most rewarding jobs ever. I have a wonderful mom, and growing up, she kind of did me a disservice. She kind of made it look so easy. My mom always had the right answer. She had the right timing. She had the right tone in every part of my life, and I'm very thankful that God gave me the mother that I did, because I wouldn't be who I am today without her. But so I had it in my head that this mothering thing was going to be a piece of cake. I was going to have this kid. I was going to, when I found out Haley was a girl, I was going to dress her all pretty, and it was just going to be really easy, because that's just, even when seeing my mother with her grandchildren, she made it look easy. But let me tell you, it is anything but easy. I found out very quickly that it wasn't. And I also found out that my mother and I, we mother two totally different ways. Social media makes it all look fun and easy, and it makes it look like anyone can do it. But what it doesn't show is a child who doesn't sleep or doesn't eat what you've made. It doesn't show the house being clean and the whole toy box being dumped out whenever you just finished and you sat down for a minute. It doesn't show the plate of spaghetti that the child tossed in the floor after it hasn't eaten all day long and you want to get it to eat. Mothering is amazing, but good comes with the bad. I came across this post on Facebook a couple of weeks ago, and I ended up sharing it on my wall because immediately whenever I read it, I felt convicted. And it had me looking at mothers in a totally different way. So after reading it, I repented of anything that I thought maybe I should have. So, but I'm going to read you this post, and I want you to put yourself in this situation and tell me, is this me or is it not? This lady wrote, "I walked by these shoes tonight, and I thought to myself, why are those even there? I'm always cleaning up messes. Then the Lord stopped me in my tracks. This isn't a mess, but it's a byproduct of my faithfulness. And all of a sudden, it's not a mess anymore. I see a pair of little shoes that had fun playing outside with family today, and I see a ball that has been well played with all day long, and I see the signs of little life in this house. Y'all, the enemy is working hard to take our eyes off what God has done in our lives. He wants to keep us thinking that the shoes on the floor and the toys that get dumped out right after you put them away and the piles of clothes that get dumped right after you just laid them out of the dryer, it sits on the couch for 3 days, the dishes piled up in the sink after a long day, and the thing that you keep asking your spouse to do over and over and over and over again, and all these things are just a burden in your life. Day after day, the enemy tries to peck at you and get your mind off what God really wants you to focus on. If you could just keep your house clean, or if you can just keep your kids acting right, or if your spouse would just do everything for you, make your family a burden and have your eyes off what is to be important. The very thing that you prayed for. So you stay frustrated, you stay angry, you stay resentful. Because how can you be graceful with your kids and graceful with your spouse whenever your mind is reeling day after day with all the frustrating things that keep building you up, that keep building up every day? You prayed for that marriage and God honored it. You prayed for those kids and God honored it. And He has honored every promise He has made to you. So I want to challenge you that when you see these things that irritate you and frustrate you, that you would stop and remind yourself of God's faithfulness and thank Him and really thank Him. I promise you that you will see a change because He saw fit to send you that spouse you prayed for. He didn't have to do that. He saw fit to give you your babies, and He didn't have to do that either. And He saw fit to give you the precious life that you have. And all because of God's grace and mercy, you have a gracious and wonderful life, and we serve a gracious and heavenly Father. After reading this, I started looking at things a little bit differently. And if you know me, sometimes the littlest of things bother me. I'm not saying that I walked up to the big, huge mess and said, "Oh, thank you, Jesus, for this mess." But, you know, I didn't do that. I wasn't jumping for joy and praising the kids for making it. But instead, I thank God for my child, and I comprehended the fact that it's because of God's faithfulness that this mess is here, and that I love these children, and I have these children to make this mess. And after I thanked Him for that, and I thank Him for all the little gifts that God blessed me with, I then tell my children to come and pick up the mess that they created. So I know when they all move out and have families of their own, I will have a clean house. I will have food in the refrigerator that they will eat. Maybe. I'll at least have it clean the way I think I would like to have it clean. I'm going to go over to their house and I'm going to ask for a plate of food and I'm going to leave it on their table. And I also know that I don't want to be so focused on the small things that I miss out on the small intimate times with my family. Some of those times, those things can wait. But sometimes the kids in that moment just need a little encouragement. They need a little, "This can wait. Let's not be so in a routine that we don't have fun or we miss out on the small blessings." But it's definitely a work in progress. So that's all that I have on the thing. I guess we're going to go ahead and do the, you going to finish it up?
All right. Truly is a wonderful gift, these kids. Give her a hand clap for these words today.